You can call it the art of fighting without fighting.
Hi, and welcome back to Kung Fu Shrimp. As anyone who's seen any of my other videos will realize, we're doing things a little different this time. I decided there was just too much information I wanted to give in this video, and the subtitles I've used previously were just not going to be up to the job. So although I swore I would never do it, you get to hear my voice on this one. One advantage of this format is that I get to say a huge thank you to everyone who's been watching and liking these videos. It's meant an awful lot to Bruce and myself, reading and replying to all the wonderful comments you've left. Please also remember, if you do enjoy watching the adventures of Bruce, you can go ahead and click that subscribe button. Who knows, maybe it'll convince me to make them on a slightly more regular basis. So, with that out of the way, let's get on with the video. So, you've decided you want to keep a peacock mantis shrimp, but you've got no idea how to look after one of these amazing creatures. That was the situation I found myself in when I first saw Bruce, decided I had to have him. When I went looking for information on keeping mantis shrimp as pets, I found out that unfortunately, there wasn't much out there. So, having owned one now for almost 3 years, and having had to figure out most of it on my own, I thought I'd put together some videos giving some advice based on what I've learned over that time. In this first video, I thought I would take you through my setup from top to bottom to give an idea of the kind of tank and equipment that are required to keep these crazy critters. Please be aware, I am not an expert, so all the information in this video is based on what I found out to work for me. Please do bear that in mind. Bruce's original tank was 25 gallons. I picked it up secondhand after reading it was a suitable size for an adult peacock mantis. However, I quickly decided it was a bit too small for him, and as I knew he still had some growing to do, I began plotting an upgrade. If you're interested in the process of migrating Bruce to his new tank, I have a video that detailed that entire process, and I'll put a link in the description below. After looking at a lot of potential tanks, and even considering having one custom made, I eventually settled on the Aquascape Reef Sys 180. It's a 180 litre, or 50 gallon sumped, cube-shaped aquarium. The first reason I chose it was the increased water volume. One of the things I struggled with in Bruce's old tank was maintaining good water quality. Mantis shrimp are messy eaters, and can have a habit of hiding leftovers if you're not careful, which can make it hard keeping the water conditions ideal. Having the increased water volume helps make sure your biological filtration can deal with this, and helps with any potential ammonia or nitrate spikes. Secondly, I really wanted a sumped tank, which as well as increasing the water volume, allows me to hide away all the equipment, as well as making sure it stays away from Bruce's devastating smashers. The final consideration was the shape of the tank. Although this was definitely impacted by the space I had available, I wanted to make sure there would be a decent amount of low-level real estate for Bruce to explore. Although mantis shrimp can swim, see my link in the description below, they don't often do it and will spend the vast majority of their time either on or near the bottom of the tank. As such, try and go for something with the largest footprint you can, as this will give more space for your mantis shrimp to stretch their legs. As for the equipment in the sump, I run a 4,000 litre Jekod return pump to make sure there's plenty of water circulating through the sump. I have a temperature controller connected to a 300 watt titanium heater and just a USB desk fan for cooling. I run the tank at 25 degrees centigrade or 77 degrees Fahrenheit. For nitrate control, I have a block of Marine Pure. This is the first time I've used this, as I tend to run a refugium in my other tanks, but I wanted to run a dark sump in this one, so I'm experimenting with purely biological filtration, except for a few macro algae in the display. And for phosphate control, I run a Phosban 150 reactor with Roafos in it, as I've never yet run a tank that didn't have excess phosphate. I also have an auto top-up for evaporation to make sure I maintain a stable salinity. Finally, I run a Bubble Magus Curve 5 skimmer, which would normally be a bit overkill for a tank this size, but as I mentioned before, Bruce is a messy eater, so the more crud I can skim out of the tank, the better. Inside the tank, the only piece of equipment is a Vortec MP10 wave maker. This is adequate for now, and I like the fact the motor is outside of the tank and away from Bruce. However, I think I may need more flow in the future, so I might have to get another one. For Bruce's home, I used standard 2-inch PVC piping I bought from a plumber's merchant. The diameter of the pipe you go for will depend on the size of your mantis shrimp, but a good rule of thumb is that it should be able to turn around in it, but not by much. They do like it fairly snug. Now this is overkill, and Bruce has already blocked off one of the entrances and rarely uses the top one. But this was kind of the point. I wanted to provide options, and it's up to him how he wants to use them. The most important thing when laying out a home for your mantis shrimp is it should provide a refuge where your mantis shrimp can escape prying eyes and feel safe. A more modest example, still perfectly acceptable, is Bruce's home from his old tank. It is far smaller than what he's got now, but importantly, through using elbow joints, I made sure that it's still a large section that is totally dark. Many people will design their mantis tank to try and make sure they can always see them, and I feel like this is the biggest mistake people make. Your mantis shrimp will be a lot happier and will come out and about a lot more if they think they can get away when they need to. This is also crucial during a molt. They will generally seal off all entrances and go into total seclusion for as much as a week. An easy thing to remember is if you can see your mantis shrimp molting, they do not have a suitable home, as this is not something they would ever do by choice. I finished off the aquascape with about 20 kilograms or 40 pounds of a mixture of Carib Sea Life Rock and Real Reef Rock. I used this to disguise the pipework as much as possible, and tried to make sure there were some low climbable sections for Bruce, as well as plenty of open sandbed. Finally, lighting. Now, strictly speaking, a mantis shrimp has no particular lighting requirements. In fact, there's anecdotal evidence that intense lighting may be a factor in mantis shrimp developing shell rot. So the path I've chosen here is definitely not the accepted route. I run an Aqualumination Hydra 26 on my aquarium, primarily because I plan for this to be a full reef tank in the future. The eagle-eyed among you may already have noticed the first coral has been added. It's a zoanthid, but I can't actually remember which variety. It seems to be doing well so far, but more will be on the way soon. I didn't want Bruce's home to just be rocks and sand. I'm not a fan of artificial corals, so I figured I'd give it a whirl. One advantage of this approach is it forces me to concentrate on maintaining pristine water conditions rather than just acceptable ones. So that's it, my mantis tank in a nutshell. For maintenance, I do a 15% water change every 2 weeks, and I clean the skimmer and filter socks whenever they need doing. And that's about it. I hope you've enjoyed this and that it was helpful to someone. I have big plans for this tank, and I hope you'll join us for the ride. If you have any questions or comments, or if you have a suggestion for a future video idea, post it down below. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.